Hello, Lee Ellis here. Thank you for joining me for the monthly coaching of Leading with Honor. Well, you know, leadership always makes a difference. And lately I've been thinking about the tremendous difference it made not only in the POW camps of North Vietnam. I've talked about that and I write about that a lot. But there's another way, and that was in the wives and families of those back home and what they did to make our life better and to really enable us to survive and make it home the way we did. You see, after about 3 years, many of these POW wives had no idea whether their husbands were alive, dead, POWs. They didn't know. Some knew, but never heard any information from their spouse, so it was just really an unknown area. And our government was encouraging them not to talk about it, not to bring it up, not to make it public. It was in the POW's best interest for them not to do that. Well, finally, after about 3 years, Sybil Stockdale, wife of Commander, later Admiral Stockdale, and some other ladies in the San Diego area, Southern California, got together to kind of talk over their situation. And they all realized they had similar concerns. Things were not happening. They didn't know if their men were going to make it. 3 years had already been POWs. This was 1968-69 time frame. So what could they do about it? Well, some people on the East Coast, wives and families there, were having the same thoughts, same thing in Florida, same thing in Dallas, Texas, and San Antonio. What happened was those families got organized and formed the National League of POW/MIA Families. And you talk about leadership, they made a difference. I won't go into all the details because I've written a blog about that, but just so you know, what they did changed the national policy of the United States government and the national policy about treatment of POWs in Vietnam by the North Vietnamese government. They caused the prisoner of war torture to stop. And we went to more of a live and let live situation because of what they did. Incredible leadership. And these were women with no formal positions and roles. They just got organized and they were committed and they made things happen. I won't go into all the details, but it made a difference. So, what about you this year as we launch out and move ahead? How are you going to make a difference? Now, one of the responsibilities of a leader is to keep things running and to keep the status quo, to make sure that all the processes that are supposed to happen keep going and all that. But also, it's a leader's responsibility to solve problems, to make things better for everyone, to achieve new results and better results, and to take the organization to the next level, higher. Well, that takes a lot. It takes, first of all, a realization of that you're not there just to occupy a role and just to kind of keep the shop running. You're there to take it to the next level. And that takes clarity. Clarity about purpose and about goals, objectives, what you really want to do, and how does that fit into the focus of your mission. Second, it takes courage, because you're going to have to confront some inertia, some people's feelings about certain things, just like those ladies had to confront Dr. Henry Kissinger and President Nixon in the White House. They actually went there and confronted him about what was happening, their lack of activity. So you're going to have courage to step out and to make things happen. And all of that's going to take commitment. You really have to believe in your cause. You have to believe in your methods and your processes. And lastly, it's going to take community. You know, those ladies built a community across the United States that brought in churches, schools, social clubs, civic clubs. Even big athletic events were having POW/MIA awareness. They got the media involved. They brought in the whole community. And there was a lot of power in that. You are going to have to inspire people in your community, in your organization, to see the need for this change that you're going to bring about and to see how it's going to make things better and to want to be a part of that. So, leadership always makes a difference. And if you're a leader, you have to make a difference. Not just keep the wheels turning at the minimum. You got to take it to the next level. And how are you going to do that this year? Clarity, courage, commitment, and community are all going to be very, very important. You have to initiate into kind of into the battle to make things happen and keep things moving. So I want to challenge you to do that. Wish you all the best this year. And by the way, I'll be back next month with another coaching session, and I hope you'll encourage your friends to join. Just go to leadingwithhonor.com. They can find the link there to sign up and join us here. Look for the blog and look for the ongoing monthly coaching. Thanks a lot.